The launch of the latest Pokemon games has been met with mountains of controversy and record-shattering financial success. This complicated duality has sparked debates regarding the future of the franchise. So, I figured it was time we talk about Pokemon Scarlet and Violet. How's it going, everyone? Miles Dompierre here. If you've been on social media, chances are you've seen the sea of memes and videos highlighting the launch state of Pokemon Scarlet and Violet. From hilarious bugs that make the characters' eyes bulge out of their head, to players literally falling through the terrain, these Pokemon titles are a little rough around the edges. The poor performance and incredibly underwhelming visuals have led some fans to legitimately question developer Game Freak and the hardware capabilities of the Nintendo Switch. In today's video, I want to share my thoughts on the situation after playing Pokemon Scarlet for a little over a week now. But before we dive into the meat of the matter, I want to hear from you. If you've been playing these games and having a blast despite the technical problems, let me know in the comments. Or if you've held off on picking up these games because of all of the issues surrounding their release, drop your takes as well. And if you're digging the content and want to show your support, be sure to tickle that like button and subscribe to the channel. Now, let's talk about Pokemon Scarlet and Violet. To stay on theme, I'll be organizing my thoughts on Pokemon Scarlet and Violet as a classic compliment sandwich. We'll start with the things I'm genuinely enjoying about the game, move on to the core problems, and finish with what this all means for future entries. Things will be a bit more freeform in this video as well, so strap in, because we have a lot to talk about. Let's start with what I love about Pokemon Scarlet and Violet. I think the transition to the open world formula works beautifully. There's something so magical about experiencing all of these new locations and seeing swarms of Pokemon roaming freely. From the very start of the game, Pokemon Scarlet lets you know that you are in control of the situation. If you see a cool Pokemon or something shiny in the distance, you are empowered to go there, and I think that is such a unique twist on the classic formula that was typically hindered by routes. The core principles of Pokemon Scarlet really amplify everything I loved about Pokemon Legends Arceus. The traversal with legendary mounts is seamless and fun, and Pokemon Scarlet gives you that ability in the first few hours of playing. One of my favorite things about Pokemon Scarlet and Violet is how the world moves around you. Wild encounters and trainer battles aren't isolated to instances anymore and happen in the open world. This means random Pokemon can move around you. There's something so fantastic about having wild encounters and seeing hordes of Psyduck and other Pokemon come and watch from the sidelines. Despite some of the jankiness associated with this approach, that was by far my favorite element of this transition to open world. Your little character feels like a part of something much bigger, and despite the rough edges, the world feels more alive than ever before. The three distinctive story arcs also empower the player to pursue the things that are most important to them. If you want to get the upgrades for your mounts, you want to chase the Path of Titans. If you want to be a Pokemon Master, you do the traditional approach and go through all the gyms. But regardless of how you play and what you do, you're constantly rewarded. As a longtime Pokemon fan, I've always wanted a legitimate co-op mode in my Pokemon games. And until now, we had never gotten it. But Pokemon Scarlet and Violet introduced untethered, four-player open-world co-op. What's beautiful about the way the co-op works in Pokemon Scarlet and Violet is that once everyone's in a room together, they are free to go anywhere they want and do anything they want without restriction. You don't have to worry about your friend being behind, you don't have to worry about your friend being too far ahead, you don't even have to worry about your friend being in the same zone. Everyone can experience their own Pokemon journeys together with the company of some great friends. There are also loads of quality of life changes that make catching and training far more streamlined. I've always loved the competitive side of Pokemon, but I've always felt it's been a tedious grind to actually get a solid competitive team. Thanks to some enhancements to items, how you get money, and Terra raid battles, it's easier than ever to actually spend time building up a team without spending dozens and dozens of hours. In many ways, this is the closest we've ever gotten to the dream Pokemon game. The transition to open world enriches everything I love about catching and battling Pokemon, and there are so many great reasons to explore this open world. All in all, for Pokemon fans, Pokemon Scarlet and Violet are undeniably fun and introduce big changes that fans have been asking for years. Now that I've waxed poetic about all the amazing things that make Pokemon Scarlet and Violet special open-world RPGs, we gotta discuss the technical problems and performance issues plaguing these games. Let's start with the performance problems, because they're pretty obvious. It's immediately apparent that Pokemon Scarlet and Violet have pretty inconsistent frame rates. There's stuttering when multiple characters are on the screen, massive frame dips when entering busier cities, and moments where the game just straight up hitches and stops for half a second at a time. Pokemon Scarlet and Violet also suffer from extremely poor draw distance as well. Textures, Pokemon, and items all occasionally pop in out of nowhere. And there's nothing more frustrating than running through the open plains on your mount and having a Rookidee force you into battle that appeared out of thin air. And the way that wall textures load in genuinely makes me motion sick because of how weird and morphy it is. It's like it's being pasted on the polygons right in front of your eyes, and it's very distracting. Pokemon Scarlet and Violet also incorporates dynamic resolution, which I think is an excellent idea for an open world game. Unfortunately, that means at the start of some wild encounters, your Pokemon look like ugly, blocky polygons instead of cute little creatures. When it comes to environments, Pokemon Scarlet and Violet has incredibly unimpressive visuals. Objects in the distance have zero definition or textures, making them appear very ugly. Faraway buildings in particular often look like they're made of clay, and it's so distracting. When it comes to certain areas like the desert or snow-capped mountains, there's pretty much no foliage or environmental details to be found, making these areas look like blank canvases of white and brown. I think what really amplifies the ugliness of the backgrounds is how great the character models and Pokemon typically look. Another huge problem for me was the lack of drip. The limitations for character clothing are so obvious and so disappointing. Because you're attending a school that requires uniforms, you're only allowed one of four seasonal outfit changes. Outside of goofy hats or helmets, it felt so hard to stand out when playing in multiplayer. Why are there so many options for socks when I can't even change my pants? My final criticism involves the catching, which just isn't as fun as Pokemon Legends Arceus. It's definitely an improvement over previous entries that use traditional catching mechanics. But after playing Arceus, I just have no interest in going back to the old ways of catching Pokemon. You're still required to weaken Pokemon, try to put them to sleep, try not to knock them out in one hit, and all of the other tedious stuff that we've dealt with for 20 years, and I'm just ready to move on to something else. Because of all of the technical issues, glitches, and ugliness surrounding the launch of Pokemon Scarlet and Violet, players have begun asking, who's to blame? On one side of the coin, you have fans claiming Game Freak should shoulder all the responsibility for the overall state of these titles. On the other side, you have vocal critics of the underpowered Nintendo Switch hardware. Ultimately, it's likely a combination of so many different things. Low-spec hardware, an unoptimized engine, and impossibly tight deadlines are not a recipe for success for any title, especially for a franchise's first foray into open-world design. I won't casually throw blame on anyone because I don't have all the information, but it's clear that moving forward, things need to dramatically change to improve the quality of these games. Despite all the problems with Pokemon Scarlet and Violet, Game Freak has laid the groundwork for an incredibly exciting future. While a lot of people have dunked on the overall visuals of Pokemon Scarlet and Violet, there are clearly some areas where the team has improved. Pokemon now have fur, scales, and reflective surfaces that can be impacted by weather events. When you encounter a Magnemite in the wild, you'll see a reflection on its body dictated by where the sun is in the sky. And character models and interior locations like the house at the beginning of the game look so much better than anything we've seen from previous entries. I also want to shout out just how rad the weather effects are. Watching grass aggressively flutter in the wind and seeing dust build up on your character's clothes during a sandstorm, it's just awesome. This one might sound a little simple and silly to discuss, but one huge improvement with this game are its physics. It's exciting to see Game Freak invest in some kind of physics engine. You'll see tumbleweed Pokemon getting blown around in the breeze. There's a moment where you have to push around a giant olive ball to access a gym. And then across the board, there's an emphasis on hair physics for all of the characters in the game as well. The Pokemon themselves have also gotten some physics flourishes. From little tufts of hair that move to jiggling bellies, this shows that Game Freak is recreating and improving many of the 3D models. The rollout of seamless online co-op presents the strongest offering for multiplayer in series history. And despite the fact that there isn't a great deal that you can actually do with your co-op companions, this sets a strong baseline for future iterations. Pokémon Legends Arceus and Pokémon Scarlet and Violet have gotten us so close to the perfect Pokémon game. There are definitely some issues, and the overall engine needs some fine-tuning, but these two titles show that Game Freak is interested in moving the series forward after years of it feeling pretty stagnant. Pokémon Scarlet and Violet definitely have some problems, but they also introduce big changes that fans have been asking for years. What are your thoughts on the state of Pokémon Scarlet and Violet? Are you playing these open-world RPGs? Let me know in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button. Thanks so much for everything you do. Keep that passion burning, and we'll catch you in the next video.